one of the colleague who perhaps is new to the committee is Grant Patterson, am I right?
Yes, sir.
Well, welcome, glad to have you here among us. The brevity of the members is the key issue here, but I sort of think that we've got a fairly straightforward agenda tonight, so hopefully that might reflect in us getting away before 9:30 with that. Well, the first item is members' code of conduct declarations of interest. Are there any? Okay. The second item on the agenda is the minutes. Is somebody willing to move that they've got a true record? It's been moved. Yeah. Happy? Okay. Well, can I just refer to the minutes? There is one item of any other business, which would be item 12, and it's referred to in your supplementary papers. With your indulgence, I'd
common practice, and certainly across the most of the books I've ever said, across all of my colleagues across the Northwest, it's a fairly well established kind of practice to internal or long routine share with the members. But you make the request, and then we'll come back to you. And then we'll determine what is.
Thank you, Chair. This might be practice, but what is the legal basis for it?
We'd have to consider the data protection issue, whether information about staff is appropriate to be processed in that way. And that also, as Mr. Dibbock said, there's no hard and fast rule. That would have to be considerations whether or not it was fair or for processing of personal data. Was it necessary in order to convey the information that was needed to reveal the individuals concerned?
I'll reflect on that. Thank you, Chair.
Chair, could I just say something briefly, because I have an answer to this. There used to be a public
Yeah,
I was just asking the chair.
Sorry.
I've got an answer for Phil Gilchrist, which will be helpful to the committee.
This is a meeting in public. It's not a public meeting.
Okay.
I hope that
bugged me ever since I came on the council that it wasn't done in some departments. But I find it odd that it has to start with managers to cascade down, because they can finish off what they haven't done first, because some people are never getting done, and that's what has been the problem. Tom's sitting here talking about it, but Tom and I have discussed it anyway on other occasions. And we do. I have tried with HR, but they seem to go on the cascading theory as well.
Okay, well, fair enough. Thank you for that.
The people cascading, but if you look at the council annual degrees in its plan, the annual degrees in its budget, as part of that will be a series of actions coming out from that, the members need to understand, the senior staff need to understand, then cascade down to the staff. That's the reason it's got to the senior members. So what has changed in terms of the council plan, the council budget, and then pass that down to the senior managers to make sure the actions that they're put in place, to make sure the actions expected of them. That's the cascade, and that's the reason.
Yes.
Yeah, I think that's a good answer, Ron.
Yeah, I think it's just a common theme, I think it might be sort of, even to mention a future meeting with the head of HR comes here. Because my concern is that we're never completing the same people each year that are being replaced. So how do we know that they're doing their job? Because that's the basis of it. It's to make sure that they are doing. So it's not being cascaded down. Whatever reason, because officers aren't doing their job. It's a simple thing, it's not me doing their job, or David or anything, it's them not doing their job completely. So the appraisals are not complete. But every year, we have shortfall on appraisals. So it's got to be the same individuals every year that don't get appraised. How do we know that they're doing due diligence in their job, and completing their job? What if there's no way of appraising?
Can I take it then that you're proposing that we invite the head of HR and other representatives to attend the meeting?
I think we should be able to a little bit stronger than inviting them. We insist that they can attend the future meeting.
I would much prefer to say that we invite them, because they're not going to be. We don't need to meet them. It's just we invite them.
To be sure, I think that's a good idea.
Is just the phrases of where we are, who's outstanding,
And the bullet points here are, of course, reflected as the items making progress in that letter. I have looked and tried to mark the letter in a careful way to look at the points where there are concerns. And I'd have to tell the committee, I'm happy to do it if you want to do it in private later, Chair, at the end, that there are a number of concerns which it would be appropriate to refer to and ask for more information of this committee. And I'm happy to do that in private later. I don't want to do it now.
I'm happy for that.
I'm happy for that.
Okay. Well, that should be.
Deadline for applications is this coming Friday, 17th of March.